IRA traitors who had some of them had joined the Communist Party. They certainly were in support of the Congress. They decided to go to Spain in ones and twos and threes. Eventually 160 of them went, and Frank Ryan articulated their position. They went to fight fascism, and they went particularly to redeem the name of Republican Ireland that had been dirtied by Owen O'Duffy. Owen O'Duffy, by the way, was in charge of the Southwestern Division in the Civil War. He was the man who sanctioned, if not by word, certainly by authority, sanctioned the main massacre of Ballyseedy Cross. So that's Owen O'Duffy, who was a champion of the Pope's army. So the international volunteers were joined by these Irishmen and formed the Connolly Column. The Connolly Column, by all contemporaneous reports from the Spanish Civil War and indeed historical reports after it, they excelled themselves because most of them had been active in the Town War and some of them indeed in the War of Independence. And these people showed their experience on the battlefield and in some of the big battles, especially at the Battle of Barama, where 25,000 of the Republican troops were killed. When Franco tried to cut the Madrid-Valencia road, was the most serious battle of the war. Franco was defeated on that occasion. At the Battle of Teruel and Veneti and different other places, IRA volunteers in the Connolly Column excelled themselves, and when they were leaving in 1938, La Faisionara, which was Dolores Ibarruri, she was a famous woman who fought for workers' rights, and she was known as the Faision Flower, and she was the heroine of the Republican forces, and she had coined the phrase in Madrid, no passer on. They shall not pass, which became a famous revolutionary quote. Like Chucky or La, for example, became that sort of a phrase. And Dolores gave every single one of the Irish in the Connolly Column an individually signed affidavit of the respect that the Spanish people had for the revolutionary forces. On the war itself, the Communist Party, who were the only party who had any real sincerity in them, the 70,000 members of the Spanish Communist Party handed themselves over lock, stock and barrel to the Republican forces. Most of the army had defected with Franco, and the Soviets themselves were the only country to support the revolution, or the Republican forces. They supplied them with whatever materials they could, some fighter planes, but at no time did the forces from the Soviets ever exceed 2,500 people, including airmen and advisors and technicians. Whereas, for example, the Italian Air Force gave somewhere in the region of 100,000 men and planes to the Franco forces. The Condor Legions of the Nazis, who practiced their bombing runs in Guernica, supplied the Franco forces with countless men, tanks, machinery, planes. So the Soviets in the Spanish Civil War certainly excelled themselves from integrity. There was some sectarian stuff going on with the Trotskyists, the POUM, and some nasty stuff that went on in Catalan and Barcelona and places like that. But in general, the Connolly Column were involved in a straightforward fight against fascism, and they excelled themselves. And when they came home in 38, they came home, as far as we're concerned, in the Republican struggle, as far as we're concerned, they were heroes.